Hi guys, it's Tuxado. If you've got a little time and are interested in my stuff, I just open commissions. Check out my Payhip for project files, editing packs, and free stuff. And if you really want to support me, please commission me, Fari. Anyway, today I'm going to show y'all how to use SI Shake in multiple ways. Plus explain how the settings actually work. BC. This was requested, he. Let's go.
First, get your clips ready. I already added a scale transition and a one-frame transition. Now drop the S-Shake effect on your clip. So let's look at how the default S-Shake looks. I'll just keyframe amplitude like this, 7, 0, 5. I usually do 3 keyframes so the shake doesn't just cut off randomly after that. I easy ease them and tweak the graph a bit. This is what it looks like without changing any settings, just amplitude. Now let's talk about what the different parts of a shake do. Amplitude, how much shake. Frequency, how fast it shakes. Increase for faster shakes, decrease for slower. Careful when animating frequency. Changes in value affect the shake too. Phase time shift of the motion. Animating this can add extra movement, but it'll also mess with the frequency feel. Z-disc changes zoom level, 1.0 is default. More than 1 equals zoom out. Less than 1 equals zoom in. Motion blur equals adds blur to the shake, optional but looks nice. Wrap X and Y, how the image behaves outside borders. I usually use reflect. All right, so let's talk about the RAND parameters in SG's shake. These are basically what make your shake look more natural or chaotic. Depends how you use them. Randam, this controls how strong or intense the random shake is. If you turn it up, the movement gets more chaotic and bouncy. If you turn it down, the shake is more subtle and chill. Like if you're going for a handheld camera vibe, try keeping this low around 0.1 to 0.3. If you want it to look more glitchy or frantic, raise it. Each direction has its own setting. X Rand Amp makes it jitter left and right. Y Rand Amp shakes up and down. Z Rand Amp zooms in and out randomly. Tilt Randam adds random rotation. Rand Freq, this is how often that random movement happens. Low Freq equals slower, smoother shake. High Freq equals fast, twitchy shake. So if you're making something like a light camera wobble, maybe go 1 or lower. But if you want that super twitchy fast jitter, boost this to like 2, 3, or even higher depending on the look. Wave parameters. Same idea, just regular repeating movement instead of random. X, Y, saw tilt wave amp shows how strong the wave motion is. X slash Y slash Z slash tilt wave frequency shows how fast it moves. Phase shows the time shift of the wave motion. How I usually do it, I mostly just animate amplitude. I don't always touch rand or wave unless I want a specific vibe. So yeah, no, fixed settings TBH. Just experiment until you like the look, my go-to method. Now, I don't really use a fixed setting. I just play with amplitude and sometimes tweak frequency. I usually don't mess with the rand or wave settings much unless I want something specific. So here's my usual setup. Patty, you should definitely explore the parameters more though, especially if you want more stylized or rhythmic shakes. And that's it. Hope this helped you understand S-Sure Shake better. It's super powerful if you know how to control it. Thanks for watching. If you found this helpful or cool or anything poyas, consider supporting me. Payhip, https://payhip.com. Suksado, Kofi commissions, PLS help a broke artist. Sub if you want. Bye, yay.